गुड आफ्टरनून फ्रेंड्स, आई एम डॉक्टर चिराग पड़ियार। आई एम वर्किंग हियर एज सीनियर मेडिकल डायरेक्टर एंड टुडे वी आर टेकिंग यू थ्रू द लैब टूर टू एश्योर यू दैट योर बेबी स्टेम सेल्स आर सेफ विद अस। दिस इज नॉट द फर्स्ट टाइम दैट वी आर फेसिंग दिस क्राइसिस। वी हैव सीन सिमिलर सिचुएशन इन 2015 व्हेन देयर वाज सीवियर फ्लड इन चेन्नई एंड इन 2017 व्हेन देयर वाज द वर्धा साइक्लोन। During both these situations, when the entire Chennai city was shut down, we were the only facility operating 24/7. This is only because we care for you, for the trust that you have shown in us, and we have got the dedicated staff to ensure that your stem cell remains safe. We are now entering the live cell facility. And I will just show you the certificates that we have for the quality assurance of our lab services. We have the ABB certification, American Association of Blood Bank, for our cord blood banking services. We also have NABL and CAP certificates for testing services. We have ISO 9001, WHO GMP and ISO 27001 certificates for our lab operations. Recently we got the license from certification from AATB, American Association of Tissue Bank, for our tissue bank division. And proud to say that we are the only company in Asia to receive AATB certification. So as I was telling you before, we have three divisions at LifeCell: the cord blood division, the diagnostic division and the biologic division. Cord blood division is till date we have stored around 3 lakh cord blood units. We are the largest cord blood bank in India and we are also the third largest in the world. Hopefully we will be number one in the next 2 years. The diagnostic division, at the diagnostic division we do genetic testing for the mother and the baby, that is the prenatal and the neonatal genetic testings are performed. And the biologic division takes care of the placental tissue based products. We are now at the SRT. So here I will just explain you in brief how the overall process works. So whenever the pregnant woman, when she develops labor pain, and at that time she calls up our call center. The call center team then locates the nearest paramedic and asks him to go to the concerned hospital. At the hospital, the paramedic does the collection. It is only a 5-minute procedure. So in 5 minutes, the cord blood is collected. Then he packs it up in this collection kit boxes. So these are temperature controlled kit boxes, specialized kit boxes, which can maintain the necessary temperature for up to 3 days. So once the cord blood is packed, collected and packed, he will then hand it over to the logistic team. The logistic team then ships it to Chennai through the available nearest available flights, and it reaches Chennai within 48 to 72 hours. And I would like to say that during this shutdown, during the lockdown, when the entire country is shut down, there are no flights, no commercial flights operating as of now, we still continue to get our samples to the lab within 48 hours, all throughout the entire month. Thanks to our logistic team, thanks to our paramedic team. So here at the lab, once the samples have reached, we have checked the sample quality and then we do the registration work. After that, the samples are then sent to the clean room, the processing room, where we do the stem cell extraction. This is our cord blood processing room. These are class 10,000 rooms, GMP compliant. And this operator is working in a class 100 biosafety cabinet. As you can see here, he is currently working on one of the corporate units. So the processing is done using a specialized technology which is called the prepacite technology. And this prepacite technology is a patented technology. The patent is with our technology partner Cryocell. And the advantage of this technology is that we can extract the maximum number of stem cells from the cord blood unit. Like today, the recovery of my stem cells in the cord blood is around 90%. Other cord blood banks who are using alternative technologies, they have a stem cell recovery of around 75-80%. So clearly, our recoveries, stem cell recoveries, are one of the best in the world. And we do ensure that this stem cells, when they are available, they are always the highest quality standards. Now I am taking you to the cryo room. So the samples which were processed in the clean room are now sent to the cryo department for further storage. And the cryo room is in the next building. So I am taking you to the next building. This is a specially designed building. So it is made earthquake proof, flood proof, and also all the other necessary fire and safety, fire safety systems are put in place. We are now at the cryo room, and this are the liquid nitrogen tanks. So you can see here the entire facility. We have got around 70 cryo tanks in the Chennai facility. We also have another 20 vessels at Manesar Delhi facility. So all the cord blood units which are processed in that clean room are now brought over here, and they will be stored in the nitrogen tanks till the day you want them back for a transplant. But the samples are stored in liquid nitrogen, and so the temperature, as you can see here, -196°C. So all the samples are maintained at this temperature throughout the course of 50 years, 70 years that you are going to store. How do we maintain this temperature? So this temperature is maintained by liquid nitrogen which is inside, and it is constantly supplied in the nitrogen tanks through these overhead tanks, through these overhead pipes. This pipeline is connected outside to a cryo tank, that is nitrogen tank, which is around 12,000 liters capacity. The temperature which is recorded in the monitor is then captured over here and brought into our centralized server. And here on this system, we can monitor the temperature of all the 70 vessels. If you have stored your stem cell units with us, if you are our cord blood customer, you can go to our website, and you can also check this temperature live throughout the day, any point of the day. So I would like to conclude this session, and I would like to say a few words to you that we are in unprecedented times. We are facing the lockdown since the past 1 month, and it's terrible emotionally, mentally, but be assured you are safe, and world has not seen this pandemic for the first time. There have been many pandemics in the past 100 years, and many of you will not know. 1918, the first pandemic which took place in 1918, the influenza pandemic. In that pandemic, 20 lakh people lost their life. This is more than the number of people who lost life in the World War I. It was a killer pandemic. Against that, you see this pandemic, we have registered only 50,000 positive cases across India. 50,000 cases. So it is a very, very small number. All thanks to the science and technologies which have advanced in the past 100 years. So you are in a very, very safe generation. You need to do your bit to remain safe. And very simple, you have to stay at home. If you are going out, you ensure social distancing, and you put your face mask on. That will keep you safe throughout this lockdown period, and we all will come out safely. My last word, you take care of your family, take care of yourself, we will take care of your stem cells. Thank you very much.